This is Houston. Say again, please.
Houston, we have a problem.
You can say that again.
Houston, we have a problem.
Shut up, Tom. I was just teasing. Jeez, man. So, we ran into a little problem. Working on Project Soundwave. Got the new cowl in. Looks pretty dope. But we got some issues. It's not what I wanted, but let's take a look.
Well, due to the long travel kit, our track width was a lot wider, and I knew this going in, but I'd never ran one of these bodies before, so I didn't know that I was gonna have the clearance issues that I did. And well, kiddos, I don't think that's gonna work. We're rubbing there and rubbing there, and I don't think even with a 20 inch tire I could get that to tuck as wide as that is. So I guess we're gonna have to pull this long travel kit off, and I think we're gonna go back down to a stock height up front, maybe put some air ride on it, maybe not, haven't decided yet. And then in the back, right now we don't have the dualies on there, we got single wheel right now. But we're gonna end up dropping that back some more, lowering it down and making this a true rat rod. Either way, that'll be pretty fun. Hopefully we get the stance fixed. So, all right, well, can't look at it all day. Let's get going.
What an idiot! Oh, what a loser!
I know out of all that, all you heard was, he's getting rid of the long travel kit. Yes, I'm getting rid of the long travel kit. No, it is not for sale. I will use it on another project. I know how hard those things are to come by right now, and I sell them. I'm not gonna get rid of mine. If you want one, better get one while you can. Yeah, they're a pain to get. Anyways, we're gonna have to take this front end off. Corey really needs the brakes off of it, especially since we're having a hard time getting those. So we'll take the brakes off, ship those to him out in South Carolina. We're gonna put a stock front end back in this cart. We're gonna get it down low. We're gonna run a 14 inch wheel with a 20 inch tire up front, tuck the wheels back in, lower the back. Corey is sending me a 2-link kit that he had. Probably gonna put it on air so that we can really tuck those 28s down. And more than likely, we're gonna end up building a custom bed for the back of this. Guys, stick with me. We got a ton of work to do on this cart. It's gonna be fun though. So, and it's still cold outside. Yes, I know, I'm in Texas. It's not supposed to get cold here, but it is freaking cold, okay? Get off my case. All right, guys, so I wanna hit on a very important part of building a custom cart. Whenever you're building something completely custom, don't just throw your stuff away and think, oh, I'm putting a long travel kit on it, I don't need my stock front end. Guys, I gave away my stock front end to somebody, and I ended up having to search around and take parts off of other carts and do stuff. So this came off of a cart, steering rack came off of another cart, springs came off of another cart, and the spindles came off another cart. Luckily, I had enough stuff around to make it work. So just remember, don't sell or get rid of your stuff until you're absolutely sure what you're gonna do is what you're gonna do. Because you never know when it's gonna come back to bite you in the you know what. Fiberglass, gotta be careful with this. You don't wanna bust it up or crack it. And these fiberglass front ends are not exactly cheap. So you can see how wide the track width is with the long travel kit. It really gets it out there. So, all right, let's unbolt this big pig. I did it again. Guys, you gotta measure. Good grief. All right, so the leaf springs that I put on the front of the Soundwave cart, I thought were the right springs. I forgot that EasyGo had two sets of leaf springs for the front. They have your standard set, and then they have a set that's a little bit longer. I should have known something was up when I went to put the steering linkage in and the steering linkage wouldn't fit correctly. I thought maybe I just had it out of adjustment. I wasn't paying attention. Well, it wasn't until I put the front end back on that I noticed that the tires were tucked too far forward in the fender well. Great. So then I had to search to see if I had an extra set of springs. Luckily, I found a stock set of springs. This time, I got to measure again just to make sure. Always measure twice, three times, four times, I don't care. Save yourself a ton of work. I got to go through and take the cowl back off. I got to pull all the front suspension back off, pull the leaves, put new leaves on it, put it back together. Don't even get me started on the back. Tucking a set of 28s is going to be a little more difficult than what I thought. I don't think it's going to be too bad. I forget that there are 28-inch tall tires in the back. Like, I wanted this thing to get low. And I think I can get it there. There's a lot of playing around that I'm going to have to mess with. Definitely going to have to fab up some stuff. I went ahead and bought a set of Monroe MA705 air shocks for the back. Yes, I said air shocks. A lot of people run them on air shocks due to the constraint of, you know, the area that you have in a golf cart. I have a little bit more room on this one because it's not your typical TXT. This was a refresher cart or a workhorse, if you want to call it that. You know, instead of having your sloped frame like I had in the back, mine's a lot more open, so it allows me to tuck the 28s up a lot higher. I think I can get the two link bars that Corey sent me down lower, and I'm gonna have to fab up a custom plate and move my shocks. If that doesn't work and it doesn't lift properly and I don't like the way it's, you know, holding, probably gonna have to mock up a set of bags. Isn't it expensive setback? Yeah, I mean, the air shocks are about $75 on Amazon. So, I mean, whatever, it cost me $150. I've blown a lot more money on stupider stuff. Anyways, let me cut to this. I'm gonna show y'all what I'm talking about. All right, guys, so what we're looking at here is the fender. The tire is tucked too far forward. There's no clearance back here, and then I've got a ton of gap back here. So you can see that the wheel is not centered in the well. It's because those springs were too stinking long. So I'm gonna take all that off, get the shorter springs on, move the front end back to where it centers inside the well. I do have 14-inch wheels coming in there, or get rid of these. These are a 22-inch tall tire, and I'm going to a 20-inch tire. That ought to help a little bit. But you still have to redo everything. It's a pain in the ass, but that's what happens when you build custom stuff and you don't measure. All right, let's go look at the back. Okay, so looking at our back setup, you can obviously tell it's not your stock EasyGo. We've got different frame rails in the back. You can see how we're not running a rear body on this cart, so it's gonna allow me to tuck the 28s up pretty tight. Problem we ran into is this cart comes with big, long bump stops. Right now, these will actually sit down and touch the axle. Our problem right now is we have an MA705 Monroe air shock. And these go, I'm gonna put this one right here. And it's supposed to go in that hole. But you can see I'm hitting the bump stops. So we're gonna cut those off flush up here. And I'm gonna end up having to cut part of this tab off because the Navitas AC kit is so long that it's gonna end up hitting this as the suspension cycles. Now getting back to being able to tuck 28s, right now I have the suspension set up on a jack. We'll show you. It sits down on the axle. You can see it lowers quite a bit. We get the air shocks put on, we'll give it a test run. Guys, we're building a custom bed for the back of this, and a lot of problems that people have is the shocks not holding the weight. But I was sitting there thinking, what if we ran four shocks instead of two? I'm not gonna have a ton of weight back there. I'm gonna have a lithium battery in the back and possibly two nitrogen cylinders or air tank and compressor. I hadn't decided yet. Either way, it's not like it's gonna be holding up a ton of weight on the back. I mean, the body is gonna be heavy because it's gonna have subwoofers in it. So live and learn. I guess we'll figure it out. Fitfo, baby. Somebody said I wouldn't cut this frame up. You know what I told them?
slugs. Don't any of you have the guts to play for blood?
I'm your huckleberry. That's just my game.
As you can see from the last video, when we put the air shocks on it, it drops, but it doesn't get low enough, at least not low enough for what I want. I really want to get this frame down as close to the ground as I can. I should probably answer that. Nah, I'll call him back. Anyway, I want to get this thing as close to the ground as I can, even with those massive tires on the back. So we're probably going to put a block underneath it. We're going to change the way we configure the shocks. And then Corey calls me and he says, man, I don't like how short the wheelbase is. We need to stretch it out. I had thought about doing a long bed, but hey, who knows? Might have to take it out to South Carolina and do some custom metal work to it. I guess we'll find out, see. Anyways, I'm gonna slap the dual wheels on the back real quick just to give you all a visual. No, I'm not gonna show you how to do it this time. Mainly because I don't really like the way I had to do it. I'm actually talking with Corey and Travis in a machine shop right now to come out with a custom set of adapters to mount these. I will show y'all the next video how I did it. I don't recommend it. I don't really care for it. It's a lot more spacers that I wanted to stack to get back to a dually. So yes, I probably will have a custom set of adapters made. We looked at building a set of wheels, but with all the golf cart wheel offsets, it's gonna be really hard to mate them back up to where it's safe. I don't wanna drive around on something that is gonna snap or chew up rear end bearings or splines or drums or, I ain't trying to mess with all that. I wanna get it correct. So next video, I will show y'all how I did it. Do I recommend it? No, but everybody wanted to see how I mounted them. So stick around for the next video. I will show y'all how I did it. Anyways, let me mount these tires up real quick. I did get my 20s in for the front and they are low. I still got to fix the suspension on the front. That'll be in the next video along with some other stuff. I got to take the body back off. We got to start building the subwoofer box / body. Yeah. Building a subwoofer box into the body, or building a body out of the subwoofer box. Either way. All right, guys. Well, this was fun. Let's do it again. Have your people call my people.